agenda. The whole issue with TTIP is that the prime...
We're now going to come to a maiden. Tulip City.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. It gives me great pleasure to make my maiden speech during the committee stage of the European Union referendum bill, a topic that is close to my heart and to the hearts of my constituents in Hampstead and Kilburn. In fact, this topic cropped up frequently during the 22 hustings that we had during the election period. And lots of people raised it. And this is indicative of the debate that we have in my constituency and the highly engaged residents that we have in Hampstead and Kilburn. A constituency that I am so proud to represent here in Westminster. But what can I say about my constituency with its deep history, its intellectuals, the melting pot of cultures and ethnicities that we have in Hampstead and Kilburn? I don't believe that any constituency has the radical background that we have when it comes to arts, social awareness, politics, architecture, and poetry. And we are home to one of London's paradises of walking and swimming. And we welcome all political leaders who want to take a walk on Hampstead Heath. Fellow walkers, and many years ago, two leaders of literature, Samuel Coleridge and John Keats, took a famous walk on Hampstead Heath where they discussed a thousand different things. Maybe they took the walk today. Instead of talking about metaphysics and nightingales, they would be talking about econometrics and the blue bird of Twitter. Indeed, Millifandom and Cameronettes. We are also proud that we housed George Orwell, when he wrote two of his most famous books, 1984 and Animal Farm, and he was down and out in both Kilburn and in Hampstead. And for someone who raised the importance of privacy, George Orwell might be turning in his grave to find out that there are now 32 CCTV cameras within 20 yards of the very room in which he wrote 1984. And for a constituency that has elected a female MP for 23 years, we were proud that we once housed Marie Stopes, who pioneered birth control for women in the aftermath of World War I. And even today, my constituency nurtures the likes of Bradley Wiggins, Mitchell and Webb, and Zadie Smith. But for me, the most important part of my constituency is the resilience of the people who live there. The teachers, the doctors, the nurses, the public sector workers, the trade unionists, the small business owners, and yes, the bankers. And lawyers as well. These are the people who in 1966 caused national shock by electing a Labour MP in the form of Ben Whittaker, and they turned this blue stained seat Labour. Ben Whittaker was a man who showed the world that Hampstead was part of a London where affluence and social conscience went hand in hand. And of course, Ben Whittaker's time in the House was important, but for me what really stood out was the work that Ben Whittaker did in raising international awareness of the plight of Armenians, and also the support that he gave to a war-torn Bangladesh in the 1970s. And then in 1992, my constituency decided once again to go against the blue national tide, and they elected my predecessor. What can I say about my predecessor? A woman in love with social justice. A lady not just with a touch of class. Glenda Jackson, the Queen of Hampstead. And other than Glenda Jackson's fervent opposition to the Iraq War, her powerful rhetoric against tuition fees, and also her advocacy for women's rights. Perhaps Glenda Jackson's most dramatic moment was when she stole the show by defying all the bookies and winning the seat for Labour by just 42 votes in 2010. Yeah. And I'm pleased that her formidable opponent from the Conservative Party now does sit on the opposite bench as the Honourable Member for Croydon South, but not the Honourable Member for Hampstead and Kilburn. And on the 7th of May this year, my constituency elected the daughter of a political asylum seeker. My mother came to Kilburn in the 1970s because 19 members of her family had been been assassinated at home. My mother and my aunt were the two surviving daughters of the founding father of Bangladesh. And I'm pleased to say that they are here in the chamber today listening to my maiden speech. Yeah. My mother came to Britain because this was a safe haven for her. And what my mother's story tells you is that immigration is not simply an economic phenomenon. Britain has been seen for many years as a safe haven for political freedom, and we must not let that slip away. And an ill-conceived net migration target that includes refugees and asylum seekers is, frankly speaking, immoral and should put us to shame. In my constituency, our welcoming attitude has been to migrants from Ireland. For refugees who were fleeing political persecution in Nazi Germany, and I'm proud to say that that tradition still stands today in Salisbury World, which is the only refugee centre to be based in a primary school in my constituency of Hampstead and Kilburn. In my constituency in Hampstead and Kilburn, we recognise the link between aspiration and immigration. We recognise that they are public services that will be put under pressure because of a larger population. We recognise that housing will be put under pressure, but we still recognise the benefits of immigration and the way it enriches us. And we believe that government should be able to take the benefits of immigration and make sure that it translates into prosperity, and we think government should be able to maintain the standards on housing and public services. Just think about this. 46% of the constituents in Hampstead and Kilburn are foreign. Foreign-born. Without an open door to immigration, we might not have Hampstead and Kilburn. If we want Britain to remain open for business, we cannot shut the door of the shop. And my fear is that this EU referendum will become a proxy referendum on immigration. Both topics require a cool head and a moral compass. And I believe that we need to work together from both sides of the House to ensure that we give people the right choice to make the right decision when it comes to voting the EU referendum.
We now come to another maiden speech, Andrea.